Welcome back to Speller Tutorial Services. In today's video, we're going to solve a quadratic equation by using the completing the square method. The new caveat here is that this leading coefficient is greater than 1. Let's begin by moving this 15 out of the way by subtracting 15 from both sides of the equation. Here we end up with 4x squared plus 32x is equal to negative 15. I want to use completing the square, but first I see that I've got a GCF on the left-hand side, so let's factor out a 4 from both of these terms. So I'm left with x squared plus 8x, and again, this is going to be equal to negative 15, and I know that I need to figure out a term or a number to put here to make this section here in parentheses a perfect square trinomial, and when I add that number, I know I need to add it also to the right-hand side to keep my equation balanced. So first I know I take this this term next to the x, its coefficient, and that's going to be 8. I'm going to divide that 8 by 2, and I need to square that result. Well, 8 divided by 2 is 4, and then 4 squared is 16. So that means I'm going to place a 16 here to the left hand side, and instead of placing a 16 here to the right hand side, I actually need to place a number that's larger. Notice that I actually factored out a 4. So what I'm actually, in actuality, what I'm adding to the left-hand side is 4 times 16. Well, 4 times 16 is 32. So what I need to do is actually, I'm sorry, not 32. 4 times 16 is 64. So what I need to do is actually add 64 to this right-hand side. So let's make that change. Instead of a 16 here, that there should be a 64. Alright, now this left-hand side is turned into 4 times x plus 4 quantity squared is equal to, and negative 15 plus 64 actually comes out to be a 49. Now we need to solve for x. I need to try to get this x by itself. The first thing I see I can do is divide both sides by 4. In doing that, these 4's cancel, and I'm left with x plus 4 quantity squared is equal to 49/4. Now to get rid of this squared portion, I need to take the square root of both sides, and in doing that, this quantity becomes x plus 4. And on the right hand side, I have plus or minus, well, the square root of 49 is 7, and the square root of 4 is 2. With the plus and minus, I now have two equations. First equation is x plus 4 is equal to 7/2. And the second equation is x plus 4 is equal to a negative 7/2. In doing that, now I need to get this x by itself. So I'm going to actually subtract 4 from both sides. So I'll subtract 4 from there and from here. These 4's cancel, and I'm left with x is equal to 7/2 minus 4. Well, and I know I need to have common denominator. So I need a denominator of 2. Well, and this is understood to be 4 over 1. Well, 1 times 2 gives me 2, so 4 times 2 will give me 8. And here I have 7 minus 8, which is going to give me a negative 1, and I keep my denominator. So my first root is a negative 1/2, and now let's work on the second root. Here again, I'm going to subtract 4 from both sides. And then subtracting 4, I end up with x is equal to negative 7/2 minus, here I just show that 4, its equivalent fraction is 8/2, so I'm just going to go ahead and put the 8/2 here. 8/2, and now I've got negative 7 minus 8 to give me a negative 15, and I keep my denominator of 2, so I see my other root is a negative 15/2. So if I were to place this in a calculator, I'm looking at a negative 0.5, and this here would be a negative 7.5 as the roots. That sums it up for this video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the same name. And as always, thank you again for watching.